Daily Flicker, June the 22nd, 1935. Battle over control. It is now the right time. Dear Mr. Poirot, well, what do you think? I believe that I won this round. The end of our affair went like clockwork, don't you feel? But the fun has only just started. I would like to draw your attention to Bexhill-on-Sea on the 25th of this month. We're having a crazy time. Best wishes, ABC. The next crime will be in Bexhill. We must warn Jap to Scotland Yard.
Did the letter indicate anything that might help the police?
To be honest, I think we can already guess something about the next victim. But I need to think about it a little more. Let us examine this more closely. Certain characters in the two letters may have similar defects. Yes, this I is weird. The W is not printed properly. The W is not printed properly. Let us examine the characters in this word. Yes, the A appears to be quite unusual. Let us examine the Yes, this I is weird. Let us examine the character. Yes, the A appears to be quite unusual. Let us examine the character. Let us examine the... Right, let us compare this with the other letter. Yes, this I is weird. However, the characters in the two words do not match. Yes, the A appears to be quite unusual. Yes, the A appears to be quite unusual. Dear Mr. Poirot, we're having a crazy... Let us examine the... The W is not printed properly. Let us examine the Right. Let us compare this with the other letter. Yes, this I is weird. However, The characters in the two words do not match. Yes, this eye. Yes, this. Right, let us compare this with the other letter. The W is not printed properly. Let us examine the characters in this word. Let us examine the Let us examine the Right. Let us No, this character does not appear to have any defects. Let us examine another word. Let us examine the characters in this word. No, this character does not appear to have any defects. Let us examine another word. Yes, this eye is weird. Yes. The I characters in the two letters do indeed have the same defects. I have to find some other similar defects to confirm my theory. The W is not printed properly. Of course, the W characters in the two letters do indeed have the same defects. I have to find some other similar defects to confirm my theory. Yes, the A appears to be quite unusual. That's right. The A characters in the two letters do indeed have the same defects. My theory was right. These two letters were written with the same typewriter. Both letters were written on the same typewriter and show the same characteristics.
You surprise me, Poirot. You usually ignore material proof.
But there is nothing usual about this case, Hastings. Nothing must be overlooked. Let us now try and get our brain cells to work.
So, Poirot, have you found something?
Oui, I believe so. But I am afraid it is not enough to stop the murderer. Let us go and see Chief Inspector Chap. I will explain there. Andover, Hampshire, population 31,200 inhabitants.
It may be time to go to Scotland Yard.
To Scotland Yard, please. Jap has invested a great deal in his career. Jap is an investigator greatly respected by his peers. Like all hunters, Hastings has always been fascinated by weapons. Alice Asher was murdered in Andover, the ABC killer's first murder. London. I really like this city. One thing is certain, you never get bored here.
Don't be so impatient.
Jap appears to be snowed under. Jap appears to already be overloaded with work. My news is not going to improve matters. Bonjour, Chief Inspector. I am afraid we have some bad news. I have just received another letter signed ABC. The next crime will be on the 25th in Bexhill-on-Sea.
Are you completely sure it's from the same person?
I have compared the two letters. There is no doubt about it.
I suppose you think he's going to carry out his threats.
I fear so.
Good God, Poirot. Bexhill is very busy at this time of year, and we have no idea who the next victim will be.
I suspect that the name of the second victim will start with B.
What on earth makes you think such a thing?
I thought about it when I saw the name Asher clearly written over the shop door of the unfortunate woman who was murdered in Andover last month. When I received the letter mentioning Bexhill, I deduced that the victim, like the town, might have been chosen by alphabetical order.
So, it's an alphabet fiend. I'm going to have a list drawn up of all the people whose name starts with B. I hope there aren't too many of them.
Bien, we should leave you to work, Chief Inspector.
You have a few days to prepare yourself.
Thank you for coming, my friends.
Poirot?
Chief Inspector Jap, your call does not bode well.
Indeed, we have just found the body of a young woman on the beach in Bexhill. An ABC was placed on the body.
We'll be there as soon as possible.
Bexhill is a delightful town. It would be nice to come back and visit.
I do not entirely agree. Walking at the beach damages my shoes, and it hurts my knee.
So the years have not spared you, my friend. It's the same for all of us.
That is exactly what I said to myself when I saw you back from your travels.
Poirot!
Do not be offended, Hastings. I can see Jap waiting for us. And from his face, I would say that things are not looking good. Bexhill seems to be a pleasant little town. Bexhill is a pretty little seaside resort with elegant architecture. Although, personally, I prefer more modern buildings.
How do you do, gentlemen?
Chief Inspector?
I fear your admirer has struck again, Poirot. We haven't yet identified the victim, but it's a young woman, 20 to 25 years old. Death occurred last night between 11:30 and 1:00, and we found an ABC guide on the body.
Was she pretty?
Come on, Poirot, that's rather out of place. It has no bearing on the murder.
Are you certain? For women, it is often the most important thing. It often decides their destiny.
The body hasn't been moved. You can see for yourself.
Has the press been informed?
Not yet, but I'm planning to. I haven't yet informed them about the presence of the ABC guide in Andover.
Nobody has reported a young woman missing?
Not for the moment.
No witnesses, I imagine.
Indeed. We've asked everybody who may have met a young woman fitting her description last night to come and see us, but I have little hope of gaining anything from it.
It's early days, Chief Inspector, and the news may not have spread around the town yet.
I hope you're right, Hastings.
This hut is locked. This hut is locked. The padlock. Braided silk belt. It may have belonged to the victim. The guide is open at the page for the Bexhill train times. These marks have been left by a rope or a braided cloth. She was a great beauty. Strange that chap didn't notice it. This key is too small to be one for a house. Without a doubt, it is for a padlock. The young woman wasn't wearing shoes or a coat, and was not carrying a bag. That's strange. Either the murderer stole her belongings, or she put them somewhere safe. Maybe so that she could bath. Apart from the marks on her neck, there are no signs of the struggle. She didn't manage to hit her assailant. Let us now try and get our brain cells to work. poor child must have been strangled with his bread belt. Unfortunately, in view of the fabric, it is unlikely that we will find any prints. Let us now try and get our brain cells to work. The medical officer should confirm that the victim was strangled with her own belt.
That's what I thought. She shows the usual signs of strangulation.
With a little luck, we'll find prints this time.
You are too optimistic, Hastings. Our killer is far too meticulous for that. The key does not fit the lock. The key does not fit. The key does not. A dual locking padlock. I need to find the code and... Firstly, I have to remove the padlock. The number is upside down. This is definitely at number 6. Firstly, I have to enter the padlock's code. It definitely was here that the victim left her belongings. The purse is full. Yet again, we can dismiss theft as the motive for the murder. Here is the watch she must have removed to prevent it from getting wet. A top brand lipstick. She liked to take care of her appearance. As well as a photo of the victim with some company. It could be useful to me. Thank you. Betty's first day at work. Mom is very proud of you. Elizabeth Barnard, 7 August 1931. So, the young lady did have a name starting with B, and she worked as a ginger cat, an establishment that must be slightly further along the beach.
Japp has gone to the police. The victim has been identified and her family had reported her disappearance. She was called?
Elizabeth Barnard, namely Betty. She worked as a ginger cat at the cafe slightly further along the beach.
But Poirot, how on earth?
Never mind. Do you have her address?
Yes, she lived with her parents on the street leading to the beach, number 22. Shall we go?
You are far too impatient, Hastings. Let the poor people take in the news first. Let us go and visit the cafe where Betty worked. With all these tourists, these shops must be thriving. With all these tourists... With all these tourists... With all these...
You in a minute, gentlemen.
This is a well-laid table. Nothing is out of place, and above all, no creases. What a pity. I don't have any change to make it work. Something tells me that she's the owner of the ginger cat. This woman must be the owner of the ginger cat. It looks like something is bothering her.
How can I help you?
A hot chocolate and a tea for my friend, please.
I'll bring it straight away.
I need to know the time range during which Betty was working on her own. This page won't help me. Where is Betty? Betty worked from 11 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. Would she have been alone at any time during her service? Betty worked from 11... No, this person is not... No, this person is not... Interesting. Betty was alone between 5 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. Who did she serve? This page won't help me. These are the different waiting staff's bills. Which ones were written by Betty? Where is Betty? Betty worked from 11. Interesting. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. Betty wasn't serving on her own at these two times. Let's keep searching. Most probably a single man, a whiskey lover, maybe the murderer. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. No, something's not right. Betty was alone at just one of these two times. This bill may have been written. Most probably a family. No, something. This bill may have... Betty wasn't serving on her own at these two... Maybe I should consult her. This bill may have... Betty wasn't serving on her own... This bill may have been written by Betty. Betty wasn't serving on her own at these two times. Let's keep searching. Where is Betty? Betty worked from 11. Interesting. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. Most probably a family. No, something's not right. Betty was alone at just one of these two times. This bill may have been written by Betty. Where is Betty? Interesting. Betty was alone between five. Most probably a single man. A whiskey lover. Maybe the murderer? No, something's not right. Betty was alone at just one of these two times. Maybe I should consult the register again. I must be missing something. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. Most probably a single man, a whiskey lover. Maybe the murderer? No, something's not right. Betty was alone at just one of these two times. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. Betty wasn't serving on her own at these two times. Let's keep searching. Most probably a family. This bill may have been written by Betty. There is probably another one. Most probably a single man, a whiskey lover. Maybe the murderer? Betty served a family and a man on his own, a whiskey drinker. Maybe the murderer? This information will help me to progress.
Gentlemen, what are you doing?
We are searching for clues, mademoiselle. My name is Hercule Poirot. I am a detective, and this is Captain Hastings. Does Betty Barnard work here?
That is correct. She should have been here a while ago. Punctuality is the first rule of politeness.
I fear that Miss Barnard will not be coming today. She has just been found, dead, on the beach a few hundred meters from the cafe.
How awful! Poor young thing. What happened?
She appears to have been murdered.
This is most distressing. How this will affect my business, I shudder to think.
What can you tell us about Miss Barnard?
Nothing, absolutely nothing. Miss Barnard was my employee. Her private life was none of my business.
You did know, at least, that she had a young man.
Indeed.
This photo was found. Is this him?
Yes, that's him, all right. But I haven't seen him for some time.
Do you think there may have been some problems between them?
I'm not on those sort of terms with my staff. Now, please excuse me, I have work to do.
The customer who ordered the whiskey might provide us more information. He may have been the last one to see Betty alive.
It is an interesting idea, Hastings. Maybe he is a regular guest. What do you think, mademoiselle?
I don't think so. Our regular guests tend to order tea and cakes. At this time of the year, there are a lot of tourists about you never see again.
That's what I thought. Time to visit Betty's home. Could it be the same buildings as on the victim's photo? This is definitely where the photo I found in the hut was taken. How do you do, mademoiselle? My name is Hercule Poirot.
I know you. You're that detective we hear all about.
I do not know if that is a compliment, but I will take it as one for now. You are Betty's sister, I believe?
Yes. My name is Megan.
Can we come in?
Please do. My parents are at the police station. I doubt they'll be up to speaking to you later.
Do not worry. We will not bother them.
Did you know your sister's plans for yesterday evening?
No. I arrived by train this morning. My parents called me in a panic when they discovered that Betty had disappeared. She went out last night, but she didn't tell them where she was going.
What was your last conversation about?
Her new dress. She wanted a pair of black stockings to go with it. Mother brought her a pair. The very day it happened. She was crying. And to think that Betty never even wore them. Poor Mummy.
Family photos and files. This gramophone is magnificent. It is a one-off, without a doubt. Barnard appeared to make music a priority in their budget. They're all Miss Modest, but the Barnards are definitely music lovers. What is she feeling at the moment?
Mr. Poirot, I don't like being stared at. If you have something to say, would you please say it to me?
Betty's older sister is not just sad, she is angry. Your sister had a fiancé, I believe?
Yes, he's called Donald Fraser. A very nice man.
Was your sister seeing anyone else?
My sister wasn't a child, sir. She used to go out. She enjoyed films, dancing. She was a very good girl who didn't hang around with men. That's what they always say, no?
I am not interested in what people say. I am interested in the truth, Mademoiselle Barnard. If you only knew how much I would like to talk with someone who does not know that your sister is dead and could provide me with a true portrait of her beyond the formalities.
The truth is that my sister was a silly little fool. I tried to reason with her, but she behaved like an idiot.
In what way?
She used to say that if she was going to marry Don, she might as well have some fun now.
I understand. Please continue.
Oh, excuse me, I have to answer that.
But of course.
Betty's room is opposite the stairs on the first floor. Feel free to take a look if you think it might be useful.
This young woman is far too clever not to have anything else for us.
Do you think she's hiding something?
That is what I'm trying to find out.
Surely you don't think she did it?
I did not say anything of the sort. But young women always ruin your judgment, Hastings. Who knows, maybe Megan was jealous of her attractive young sister.
I see. She may have had her sights on the inheritance. Or maybe she was in love with Donald Fraser.
We have to study all scenarios, even the most unlikely. But I doubt that Mr. and Mrs. Barnard are rich enough to justify murder. While I try and get Miss Barnard to talk, I would like you to try and find Donald Fraser. It should be easy to find the estate agents where he works. Bring him to the Ginger Cat. I would like to talk with him before the Chief Inspector finds him. They're all Miss Mod. It looks like Betty was also a music lover. The same as her family. Without a doubt, Betty used to sing. A box of new stockings. It looks like Betty has a very busy life. Betty liked luxury and going out, and being as pretty as she was, she probably did not have any problem getting herself invited. Looking at all the clothes she took out, Betty must have had a problem deciding what to wear. Maybe she had a date? This small key should be useful to me. I've finished with this subject. Medicine to prevent voice loss. Did Betty have problems with her voice? A record sleeve with a handwritten title. Betty must have recorded a demo. I'd be interested to hear it. Something on this clock bothers me. This metal disc is stuck. This wooden panel is black. Strange. A sheet of... Strange. What a strange mechanism. I don't think it serves to turn hands. cogs are blocked by these wooden panels. The cogs are blocked. This metal disc is This metal disc is Something on this clock bothers me. I have not finished in Without a doubt, Betty used to sing. Something on this clock bothers me. This wooden panel is blocked. I can't. This wooden panel is blocked. This wooden panel is What a strange mechanism. The cogs are blocked. The cogs are blocked. Cogs are blocked. The cogs are blocked by these wooden panels. The cogs are blocked. The cogs are blocked. There, that's better. This metal disc The cogs are blocked by these wooden panels. The cogs are blocked by these wooden panels. Strange. A sheet of... This decoration appears to be firmly fastened. This decoration appears to be... Strange. This wooden panel is blocked. This decoration appears to be... Could the screw be slightly loose? This wooden panel is blocked. This leg is not well... This leg is not well attached. Good. It should be possible to open the wooden panel. Look! A key! This could be useful. This code probably has something to do with the mechanism above the clock. This decoration appears... This decoration appears... This metal disc is stuck. This metal disc is stuck. The cogs are blocked by... This code probably has something to do with the mechanism above the clock. This code probably... I definitely need... The central cog is blocked. I definitely... A new lock has appeared. A new lock has appeared. This metal disc is stuck. A new lock has appeared. Something clicked on the front of the clock. A new lock has appeared. This could be useful. Betty, I enjoyed a wonderful evening in your company, and I hope that we will see each other again very soon. D. My dearest Betty, I know that your art is already spoken for, but you are the most beautiful dancer I have ever had the pleasure of meeting, and I am impatient to see you again, Adrian. Without a doubt, Betty used to sing. Without a doubt, Betty used to sing. Let us see. What is this cupboard hiding? This looks like solfège. There is bound to be a clue somewhere. I cannot open it. I cannot open it. Looks like something goes in here. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. I cannot open it. I cannot open it. doesn't work. There is bound to be a clue. This looks like solfège. This looks like solfège. There is bound to be a clue somewhere. There is bound to be a clue somewhere. There is bound to be a clue. There is bound to be a clue somewhere. This looks like solfège. There is probably a link with what I saw in the drawer. There is bound to be a I heard the sound of a mechanism being triggered. Doesn't work. I must... I cannot open it. Just have to put the record on the gramophone and start it. That doesn't work. I must...
of recording.
Sorry, Betty, but it's not wise. The doctor said you should rest your voice.
You're such a killjoy sometimes.
Betty was such a good singer.
It's true. Did she have any problem with her throat?
Yes, she had to be careful with her voice. Of course she didn't follow the doctor's advice. If Don didn't insist, she... Well, it's too late for all that now.
I've finished with the... It looks like this woman is single, but she has feelings for someone. She is looking so intensely at this photo. But is it really a sister that she's studying in this manner? They made the perfect couple, am I correct?
Yes, in a way. She was pretty and he...
Well?
He's a bright man, with a promising career ahead of him. He would have made Betty a good husband. He was always attentive and generous. Oh, a true gentleman.
I hear a note of envy in your voice.
You must have heard wrong.
Donald appeared to be very much in love with your sister.
Yes, he was mad about her.
Mad, you say? Being madly in love can often be destructive, and Mr. Fraser was known for being jealous, I believe.
No more than average. Men are always slightly possessive, especially when they are with a pretty woman.
I am not your enemy, Mademoiselle Bernard.
And you are not my friend either, Mr. Poirot, sir.
Yes, but your lies are not helping Mr. Fraser, or you for that matter. I know that Fraser was jealous, but I wonder why you feel the need to protect him.
Protect him? I hope you're not suggesting...
That you are Fraser's accomplice? There is nothing to suggest that, at least not yet. It would appear that your sister's murder is the second in a series that we have to stop as quickly as possible. The first was in Andover, and the same as your sister, the murderer sent me a letter informing me that a crime would be committed in that town. Now can I count on your honesty?
Yes, you have my confidence, Mr. Poirot. Don is a quiet and sensitive young man, slightly reserved too. And as is often the case with reserved people, when he flew into a temper, he completely lost control. He could be so violent. Betty was frightened.
And when was this?
The first time was about a year ago. But they rowed more recently. Donald found out that Betty had lied to him. She said she was going out with a girlfriend, but she went out for dinner with a married man. It was an awful scene. She told him that until they were married, she was free to go with whoever she pleased. Donald turned quite pale and started shaking and kept saying, one day...
Well?
He'd commit murder.
Do you think that is what happened?
No, Mr. Poirot, I don't believe that. You yourself said he may be a recidivist madman. Don loved Betty with all his heart. I can't imagine for one instant that he would hurt her.
Very good, Mademoiselle Bernard. Thank you for your help.
Fraser is at the Ginger Cat. The police haven't spoken to him, but they want to.
Très bien, Hastings. Let's see him now. Au revoir, Mademoiselle. My deepest condolences to your parents.
Of course, Mr. Poirot. And don't be too hard on Don. He's more fragile than he looks.
If you say so. Let us now try... Let us now try and get our brain cells to work. Hastings always pays more attention when young women are big. You've seen Fraser, Hastings. What is your feeling?
He's a big chap. Fragile isn't exactly the word that springs to mind. I talked to his landlady before seeing him. She went to bed at 11. Fraser wasn't home yet.
Bien. Megan Barnard said he is a reserved character but with a nasty temper. We will see if this is the case. This is a well-laid... How do you do, Mr. Fraser?
You're Hercule Poirot. Mr. Hastings said you wanted to speak to me.
Yes. I know that it may not be at the right time, but I would like to ask you a few questions. This man looks suspicious. Fraser is in a terrible state, as if he hadn't slept all night, and he's drinking White Horse.
Leave me alone. Tell me that it's a mistake, that Betty isn't dead.
Sadly, your lady friend has been murdered, Mr. Fraser.
Oh, Betty, if only you'd listened.
Did you visit Betty yesterday afternoon?
No, I haven't seen Betty for 2 days. I was at the office yesterday afternoon.
Can you prove that?
Of course. But why this question? Betty died yesterday evening, didn't she?
Yesterday, a guest came to the Ginger Cat alone and ordered a White Horse whiskey, and by the look of it, you also appear to be fond of this brand.
Yes, it's a good whiskey and not cheap. I only drink it on special occasions. Or tragic ones.
I understand. Do you know what Betty's plans were yesterday evening?
She said she was having dinner with her sister.
And you believed her?
And why not, sir? She was my fiancée.
That did not stop her from lying to you before. Betty was not a bad girl, but she did like to take advantage of her success with men.
How dare you sully her memory!
I am not interested in memories of her, Mr. Fraser. I am looking for a killer, and I need you to be my closest ally. That is, unless you have something to hide.
Of course I don't.
Très bien. So, what were we saying? Where were you yesterday evening?
I looked everywhere for her, but in vain. When she said she was going to have dinner with her sister on a weekday, I thought it was strange. I tried not to think about it, but I was like a lion in a cage. I was convinced she was lying. So I went round all the restaurants in the town. When I didn't find her, I went to the next town. But nothing. I must have got home about midnight or 1 o'clock.
Did anybody see you?
I don't think so. I didn't talk to anybody. I was so furious.
Ah, I knew I'd find you here, Poirot. I thought the victim's young man was here.
Yes, he's all yours, Chief Inspector. Let us now try and get our brain cells to work.
Fraser doesn't have an alibi and he's extremely jealous.
You are very skilled at summing up.
And yet you haven't asked Japp to arrest him.
It is too soon. But I agree, without the letters announcing the crimes, Fraser would already be behind bars. Bon, I think we have enough elements. Let's reconstruct the events at the scene of the crime.
I can't imagine how the murderer wasn't seen, though. Surely she must have struggled.
Let us try and imagine the scene. The killer and the victim are walking on the beach. Miss Betty has a bag, a belt around her waist, and carries her shoes in her hand. Both of them walk slowly to hut number 5.
Miss Betty enters the hut.
No. It wasn't hut number 5. Let us think again, mon cher. The killer and the victim are walking on the beach. Miss Betty has a bag, a belt around the waist, and carries her shoes in her hand. Both of them walk slowly to hut number 5. Both of them walk slowly to hut number 6. Miss Betty enters the hut. She leaves without her belongings. Then she hides a coat. They keep walking. Then she removes a belt.
The murderer moves behind her and then attacks her by surprise. The body falls, lifeless, on the sand.
Everything appears to match the crime scene, mon cher Hastings. That is exactly what happened. Without the ABC, we might have suspected Mr. Asher and Mr. Fraser. But by signing his crimes, the murderer is making sure he's accused. In a way, it is very generous of him.
Generous? The murderer seduced Betty in order to lure her to the beach and kill her.
Indeed, the young woman was certainly careless, but not stupid enough to follow a stranger.
What are you planning to do, Poirot?
Return to London, mon cher Hastings. This is definitely where the photo I found in the hut was taken.
Japp has decided to reveal details to the press. The alphabet murder is now famous.
It is not a bad idea. The more people who know, the greater our chances of finding out something of interest.
Poirot, I have a bad feeling. Poor Mr. Poirot, not so good at these little criminal matters as you thought yourself, are you? Rather past your prime, perhaps. Let us see if you can do any better this time. This time, it's an easy one. Churston on the 30th. Do try and do something about it. It's a bit dull having it all my own way, you know. Good hunting. Ever yours, ABC. Good hunting. Did you hear that, Poirot? The murderer seems to be taking it all as a game, a challenge. He will strike on 30th in Churston. We must warn Scotland Yard.
Hastings, today is the 30s.
No time to lose. We must prepare our suitcases for Churston.
Mon Dieu, it is already 10 o'clock. I will call Scotland Yard immediately.